Hi guys, hot on the heels of the scandal surrounding grooming gangs in the UK, where mostly men who are followers of Islam went and got naive girls to trust them only to then rape and otherwise abuse them, Hamza Redbeard has the solution: more Islam. Because Islam does not mention that men are allowed to rape unsuspecting girls. Really? I have a Quran and countless examples from the secondary Islamic literature that say otherwise. I agree these don't use the words grooming or rape as such, but the principle, the concept is there. Does Islam prohibit rape? No, it does not. It specifically condones it when women are slaves, conquered property. The hypocrisy and blatant dishonesty of this man becomes apparent when you compare his words to his actions. Does Islam allow for lies and deceit? No. Does Islam propagate censorship and illegal actions to silence others? No. Yet, here, this is exactly what E.F. Dawa, the channel of Redhead Hamza, what it did, what happened. He lied. He made a false copyright claim. When real people looked at it, my video was reinstated. But he actively tried to get my opinion removed, tried to curb free speech, illegally. Because he is desperate and scared of the truth. And that's why he now tries to blame the girls and society, the victims, for being raped and abused, and tries to make it look as though the girls and society have failed and installing more Sharia will protect girls. No. Education and information will help solve this problem, not more Islam. Islam does not prohibit owning human beings. Islam does not prohibit rape. But Islam discourages, explicitly discourages the behavior he is exhibiting on a daily basis. And something I've pointed out in my video where I critiqued his vile and primitive conduct. Mentioning alcohol a lot might impress his followers, but those of us who are decent because it is humanitarian, we don't see it that way. We try and find a solution, not look for a way to simply relabel the problem superficially, then maybe it will go away. Nah. Instead of being honest and displaying some sort of moral attitude, he lies and deceives and blames society for the actions of some sick and evil men. Is this what happens to us when we accept Islam?